Malo and welcome to episode 82 of Breakfast Bites by TeRovoSports.com, a wrap of Pacifica People's Sports on this cloudy Tuesday morning, 20th September 2022, coming to you from Paradise on the 180th meridian in the middle of the Pacific Ocean.
Go, Papa, go, Pepperoni! Yeehaw!
Thank you, girls. In AFL, you know the game Aussie men love to play wearing really tight shorts? Well, superstar Lance Buddy Franklin will remain a Sydney Swan in 2023. The legendary forward confirmed yesterday that he would re-sign for another year, 5 days out from the 2022 AFL Grand Final. Go, Buddy, go. In a tribute to Michael Jordan's famous two-word facts that announced his return to the NBA, the Sydney Swans club tweeted, "One more." In rugby, Prime Minister of Fiji and President of the Fiji Rugby Union, Vorenge Mbaini Marama, attended the state funeral for Queen Elizabeth II in London overnight, among hundreds of heads of state, including US President Joe Biden. God save the Queen and long live King Charles III. And to the All Blacks, we can't have mental lapses which gave them easy tries and the ability to make it a contest. Down the stretch, we shot ourselves in the foot, gave up a comprehensive lead, and a lot of it was individual errors or mental lapses. So said Beauden Barrett, being honest about the All Blacks' last win versus the Wallabies. In rugby league, Brad Arthur, coach of the Parramatta Eels, moved training so his star halfback, Mitch Moses, could attend his grandmother Barbara Elias's funeral on Monday, as they count down to a semi-final against the Cowboys in Townsville on Friday for a spot in the NRL Grand Final against either the Panthers or the Rabbitohs. Wanna bet? In boxing, after he posted a video of his new physique on social media, Mad Irishman Conor McGregor has been accused of using steroids. Definitely had a dose of the Canelo steroids, gone from Bambi to the Incredible Hulk after a leg break, someone posted. The most steroids we've ever seen, added another. So definitely not McGregor's fans. And news from the USA. Sports teams from the Big Apple, New York, dominate the list of the world's most valuable sports teams, with the Major League Baseball New York Yankees and the NFL New York Giants valued at US$6 billion each, both in the top five, by the way, of that list by Forbes. The NBA New York Knicks, valued at $5.8 billion, and the New York Rangers, the most valuable NHL team, valued at US$2 billion. In netball, the Silver Ferns series with Jamaica is in total disarray, with reports that the remaining five Jamaican players of the touring squad will not arrive in New Zealand in time for the scheduled games. The Sunshine Girls were set to arrive in Auckland last Friday for the Tiny Jameson Trophy Series, but they didn't receive essential travel paperwork until Sunday, forcing the series to be shortened, only to two tests played in Auckland starting tonight and the second on Thursday. Hey man, you can't be blaming the Sunshine Girls demissing the flight on purpose, man. It'd be too cold in New Zealand. For TeRovoSports.com, I'm Calden Kamea. Mahalo, vina'a, and thank you. Please hit the subscribe button below if you'd like to receive more Pacifica sports highlights on Breakfast Bites. And thank you, Tumas, for all your love and support.
Bye!